Former club, Leeds United, have been across all the headlines this week. And the pretty remarkable story, Marcelo Bielsa and that brilliant press conference in many ways yesterday. Firstly, the start of all this, it came from a member of the Leeds United staff being found spying on Derby County ahead of the game last week.
Yes.
Do you have any issue with spying on opposition training sessions?
I don't think, well, to be honest, in my day now, I never heard of it, Nathan, and I wouldn't agree with it. Anyway, I mean, I never did it. I never thought of doing it. Wouldn't believe in doing it. I think the actual spying thing is exaggerated. I don't mean what he did is exaggerated, but the actual spying on the team on the Friday night is exaggerated.
The benefits.
The benefits. Very, very much so, Nathan. I think it's absolutely ridiculous. And I don't agree with what he did. And his response to it, as we know, has been, I've always done it. And what he did yesterday was very, very clever with the newspaper lads, where he showed them that he'd known Derby, watched them 6 or 7 or 8 times before.
So 51 times, he said. They had analysed 51 games.
Yeah. So I'd have to say to him, well, why do you bother going down on a Friday to see them if you know everything about them? What's the point to it? There's no gain in it. You know what I mean?
Well, I think in some ways he admitted that himself. He said, even the analysis of watching 51 games, and they said each of those 51 games took 4 hours of analysis. He said, it doesn't come to anything, but he just doesn't feel as if he's properly prepared if that work hasn't been put in.
He's right in what he does, because you don't know what you're missing or not missing until you actually see it. I can understand why he's doing it, but with the experience that he's had over the years, and it counts to little or nothing, then you'd have to say in this day and age, well, why do you do it? You know, well, what he's saying is, well, where I come from, it's not illegal, but it's not. To be honest, I never ever thought of doing it I didn't believe in watching the opposition all that much, anyway.
So would you have done any opposition analysis?
Very little, because
what would you have liked to have known?
Hmm?
What would you have liked to have known ahead of a game about the opposition?
Well, the main thing you know is from corner kicks, free kicks, what they do. That's right. Like, no matter what you knew about, in my day, I knew, played against Bobby Charlton on a regular basis. I knew what Bobby Charlton could do. How do you stop him? Do you know what I mean? Like, I played against Darbest and Charlton in my Leeds days. You knew what they could do. But how do you stop them? That's what great players do. It's exaggerated. And my take on football when I played and in management, I played with Leeds for 12 years and 11 years under Don Revie. After 11 years, and Don really was great for detail, one of the best organised teams ever, right? At the 11th year, we still didn't have it right. We were still learning, right? That was with a great team who were winning trophies, right? And the point I'm making there is that, for example, we played Swansea in the Cup one year. They were in the fourth division. And on the Friday, of course, their coach who came up to watch the week said, I've seen weakness in the Leeds team. Right? What about the weakness in your own team? See, my take on it always was, the only team you have control of is your own team. Right? So if you get your team doing everything that you want to do, you will naturally expose the weakness in the opposition. So there's no great point in concentrating on the weakness of the opposition if you've got weaknesses yourself. Put them right.
Yeah.
Put them right. And of course, you have to watch the opposition. And in my day, you'd know them because you played against them year after year. You respect them. And definite corner kicks, free kicks, throw-ins. But you've played against them the year before, Nathan. There's no great secret in it. Do you know what I mean?
I guess in the Championship in particular, even though Bielsa says he's done this throughout his career, managers change so quickly, players change so quickly that from season to season there can be quite a turnover. The team you play, the Derby team of this year under Frank Lampard, is very different to a year ago.
Well, is it? You know, see, this is the point I'm making. Of course they have different players and new players. But, I mean, there's nothing so startlingly different in football. You know, like, it's about players, about good players, what they do on the day. And if I'm playing against Bobby Charlton, I know what Bobby Charlton's going to do, right? Stop him and do something else. Like, this is what makes good players. I mean, if it was that stereotyped that you say, that Joe Bloggs does that, we'll stop him doing that. Like, Messi playing. Look, Messi, everybody knows how Messi plays. They played against him time and watched him time after time after time, but they can't stop him. But the whole general point, what I felt on here playing football, get your whole team in order. Right, and I'm saying I played with Leeds for 11 years under Don Revie, and up to the last day he was there, we still didn't get it right, 100%. So you never get your, well, very few managers get their own team right without worrying about the opposition. Of course, you've got to respect the opposition. And if you're playing against, I played against Tony Hatley, for example, who's great in the air, of course you're going to mark him from corner kicks. You know that. Mm. Throw ins, you have to be quick, but you know that before you go out. But you have to concentrate. Now you have to concentrate. What are we doing? Are we doing everything right? No. Let's put everything right that we can. Then you take on the opposition. There's only one ball on the pitch, Nathan, and if you do all the things you want to do right, you will naturally expose the weaknesses in the opposition. So, like last week, I don't think he was right to do what he did. I think he was clever in the way he responded to it by saying, I didn't do anything illegal, but it would be against the spirit of the game. Now, I saw Martin Cohen talking in the paper today where he said he was, you know, I think he was a bit disgusted about it. It's about the game and being fair. And at the same time, he's admitting when he played, he did a few things that weren't exactly right.
Yeah, where do you draw the line?
Well, where's the draw the line now? What about the diving and messing about? Mm. I'll tell you what, he does have to learn, the Leeds manager, to control his team from corner kicks and free kicks, where they're one of the most ill-disciplined team that I've ever seen, with pulling and pushing, and they're going to pay the price for it one of these days. I think he should concentrate on that, rather than, and he'd learn more and win more matches from with that than looking at the opposition.
Well, I did wonder on that side of it whether yesterday was interesting, because he basically revealed Derby's tactics for 51 games to the entire world, but revealed very little actually about Leeds and what he does.
There's not that, honestly, I know, I don't mean to interrupt you here, but there's very little that you'd learn from the opposition in tactics. Do you know what I mean? There's so much made of tactics now, it's totally exaggerated, Nathan. When you go out on the pitch, there's a ball there and you have to play. Right, you can come out with a tactic, but tactics and for footballers and what the great players are made of is doing what's right in that particular incident, you know. Mm. Now, obviously, if they've got a big centre forward and that and there's corner kicks, you've got to be aware of that and you've got to come. But the actual play, and I read it, see about and hear about tactics, got to change their tactics. Right, I've seen a match one time where this team was playing rubbish, there were three down at half time, and it came to one of the analysts at half time. What if, and they were passing the ball all over, kicking the ball out of play, doing all sorts of things wrong. What have they got to do? Well, they've got to put another player in the middle of the field. They've got to push the fullback forward. Well, they didn't have to. They had to play with the ball. They had to actually pass the ball to each other. Mm. That's the tactic. You know, obviously you've got to have a formation. You've had fullbacks and the, but that's, is that a tactic? Or is the extra man in the middle of the field a tactic? You've still got to go and play the ball. You know, play ball. So there's too much made, I think, of the tactics. I mean, Derby, like everybody knows, and what he did was very clever. Actually, I think the journalists enjoyed what he was doing, because he was pointing out what Derby do and didn't do, and I think they were fascinated by that, which is great. But he knows that. He doesn't have to go spying on them to do it. And if Derby do a certain thing, I mean, again, you go back to the great Barcelona team when Messi and
Xavi and Iniesta.
All these guys were great players. How do you stop them? You know, how do you stop Bobby Charlton and Dennis Law from, how do you stop them? Because if you do that, they do something else. That's what great players do. There isn't any one way of doing it. You know, that's what great players do. They understand the situation very, very quickly, adapt to the situation. You say, Bobby Charlton said, you put him, send him down the right side on his right foot, go on his left foot.
Do you not give yourself every chance, though, say, with the level of detail that is available and the fact that every match is now videoed, that I guess yesterday in some ways was a show of strength of how hard he works, that he's ruling out. So you say, like, and he would have come up, say, against Barcelona, and you mentioned that after losing to Barcelona, Pep Guardiola said, you know more about my players than I do. Maybe that backs up your point that he still lost the game.
Yes, game 3-0.
You're ruling out. So you come up with 50 different ways to stop Messi, Iniesta and Xavi. And if Barca find a 51st, you say, fine. But they're not going to run all over us. They're not going to do what they usually do. They'll come up against something different when they play us.
They beat them 3-0 on today. I think what he was saying as well, that if he doesn't do this, he's actually bored. Mm. And he feels that he's not doing... he's right in many ways, because no matter what... If you look at a match and you say, well, I saw that team playing 10 times before, it doesn't mean you don't learn something from the 11th match. Mm. And I think that's what he was trying to say. You know, he was saying, I've seen all these teams before. I've had them on the thing, but there might be something. And if there's something that I'm missing, I can't rest.
Yeah, I won't sleep at night if I think there's something out there that's available.
It's a bit of an illness, really, in many ways.
It's an addiction.
Do you know what I'm saying? Because he can't rest till he actually sees it. And when he sees it, he says, well, I haven't learned anything there, which is okay, as long as you don't have to overdo it. You don't have to have people spying in the trees to see what they're doing when you've watched them 10 times, Nathan. Do you know what I mean? But what he's saying is, I can't help myself from doing it. That's what he's actually saying. In other words, he's saying, there's no great benefit in it. We didn't get any benefit from it, Dad, because we knew what he would do.
Yeah.
But my personality is such, and my mind is such, that I'm bored, or I feel that I should be doing it. It's a bit of an illness in certain ways.
Yeah.
I can understand what he's saying, because, you know, like when you're in management, obviously, when I was a manager, I'd be watching, say, Manchester City play, and say, well, nothing I really learned there, but I've watched it. So there's a peace of mind about it, just in case you have. Now, he's carried that to the extreme, you know? But when they talk about, well, you know, cheating and that in the game, is it cheating? Well, it's not right. They shouldn't be doing it. But what he's learning and benefiting from is very, very little when you consider what actually is happening to his own team, Nathan. I'll tell you, I'll guarantee you in the next few weeks, they will lose a couple of penalty kicks that could be vital to them, because they're one of the most disciplined teams I've seen playing for grabbing and doing that. They're doing it very, very badly, and they'd be found out. Now, what I would say in the overall thing, he should be concentrating on that, stopping that in his own team. He can control that and stop that. Whereas he's letting that go, and he's watching the match that the team that he knows everything about.
Mm.
Anyway, so I would say he should prioritise what his own team are doing, or certainly not doing, in terms of discipline.
It's obviously going very well for them in the Championship. They're 4 points clear at the top. What's the word that you're hearing around Leeds for Bielsa? I get the sense there's a lot of love from him, particularly after this, a bit of a siege mentality for the rest of the season.
It will, and where he's been very clever in doing this particular thing, he's admitted it. He hasn't tried to cover it up. What he's saying was, I've always done it. There's nothing illegal in it, and I'm not learning that much from it anyway. Now, again, I don't think he should be doing it. You know, I think there should be a law that it is illegal in football. To do it,
yeah,
you know. But anyway,
that'll come in.
But how he's doing?
Of,
I was at Leeds last week. I was up at Leeds last week, Nathan, because Eddie Gray got in touch with me to go to. They're doing stones around the Billy Bremner.
About the former players.
For some of the former, they put my thing down, and then supporters buy into the whatever. I don't know exactly how it works, but I went up. It's always nice to go to Leeds and see Eddie and Peter, and a few of the lads, and. I was doing a bit for the radio, local radio, and I was up there at 2 o'clock to meet somebody because the movie, and there was nobody there at 2 o'clock. There was three lads there. Oh, that's great, they're here on time. There were three Irish lads. There was loads of Irish the atmosphere around Leeds is unbelievable. Now that they're looking like they're doing something, well, they are doing something, not looking like they're doing it, which is very, very good. So there's a great atmosphere around the place. I think they had, 38,000, 39,000 there?
Yeah, it's remarkable.